All right, we're doing everything we can to make, I've stuck on it.
I know, it's Hayley Orrantia.
Hayley Orrantia cry, not because of that, but rather because of Jessica's love for the Goldbergs.
I do.
Share with the class what we were just sharing with Hayley.
I said every time, well, first of all, the first episode of the Goldbergs, I came in the next day and I said, Sam, this show is fantastic. And then I told Hayley, I said, every time, just at the very end, you don't think it's going to happen, you cry a little.
Yeah, we'd like to just have a little tearjerker there in act three every time.
Every time.
You know what's funny? This show makes me feel the same way. Every time, about 10:30.
Yeah.
The show that we're on.
Yeah, the current show you're doing.
Yeah. We cry from act one.
Right.
And for different reasons.
We're crying all the way through.
Yeah.
All right, here you are minding your business in Dallas.
Yeah.
How did you book this show?
The Goldbergs.
Yeah.
Well, it's just a long process of auditioning. Long story short, when I started out with music, record labels told me that they wanted to have me have a platform before they invested in me as a musical artist, which I guess in that case meant have a television show.
Right. A very successful.
Right around the time that, you know, the Hannah Montana thing was happening.
Right.
So it like all kind of tied together. So I tried auditioning, started about when I was 15, and I'd never booked anything until the Goldbergs. And so I was very, very lucky.
So you
yeah.
didn't book anything.
Wow.
You booked the best thing.
I know a lot of my friends who have been actors for a long time hate that I say that,
right.
But it's like, you know, I put some audition time in, and I got very, very lucky to work on such a fun show that's also going so long.
Well, at one point just before that, you go, I'm done with it. It's not going to happen, did you?
There was a part of me, yeah, that was, I had done years of auditioning, and then I ended up doing The X Factor back in 2011. Mm-hmm. I was put into a country pop girl group on the show. And so somewhere after that, I was like, you know what, I'll try auditioning again. We'll see what happens. Like, and I grew to love acting the same way I love music. So it was, you know, fun to see what
And what was the X Factor thing, and the fact that they sometimes sort of manufacture these groups,
mm-hmm.
was that a positive experience or did
you know, I'm not,
so
going to lie. Okay. It was a positive and negative experience.
Okay.
There's a lot about those shows that people don't know, and there's a lot that goes on behind the scenes, because at the end of the day, it is a show. But I'm very thankful that I got to meet some incredible people along the way, and I learned a lot about the industry. So mm-hmm. it was a good stepping stone.
Hayley, diplomacy is your next gig,
yes.
by the way. All right, to the Goldbergs, I was telling you, Jeff Garland, a friend of our show, is how funny he is.
Mm-hmm.
Your TV little brother, we're going to look at a clip in a second. I mean, do you feel this familial sense with everybody?
I do. We've gotten so close over the last 4 years, and we've already got picked up for two more seasons, so we're going to be even closer by the end of all this.
Yeah.
But it's great. I mean, we've really become a family, and whenever I'm not working, I actually just go hang out on set because they're like my best friends.
Mm-hmm.
So we're really close.
And you're too young, but does the 80s stuff amuse you?
There are times, but there's times where I don't get it, unfortunately.
Yeah.
I mean, but for the most part, like, I grew up and I was familiar with all the movies and the music and even the fashion. That's us celebrating our 100th episode.
Well, that's a real accomplishment. Did they have a good cake?
They did. It was made out of, they made it look like a TV and had all these VHS tapes around it, and it was really
There good. Was an episode recently where it showed off the fact that you are a singer. It's where you and your brother told the Jeff Garland, who plays your dad, that you will create the best song of all time
yeah.
if he buys you a CD, and then if
yes.
you do, he has to buy you a CD player.
Exactly, yep.
Which was the rage at the time.
I know, so they do a lot of good balances, at least for me. The character was not originally supposed to be musical, and I said, hey, if there's ever an opportunity.
Right.
And so they've been really good about writing in not only songs that I can cover that are from the 80s, but they also do original songs like that one with Barry and Erica. And,
yeah.
and so there's a little balance of original songs from the Goldbergs and covers.
And what was the title of that one? It was funny. The original.
Oh my gosh. I can't even tell
love
you.
Love is a ninja.
Love Ninja.
Love Ninja.
Yes. That's a popular one.
Have you had a favorite cover?
My favorite cover was probably Somebody to Love.
Oh, okay.
That was one for me as a singer, that was one of the most fun ones that we got to sing.
Yeah. All right, here, a look. Hayley hard at work on the Goldbergs one.
You get to write papers on the best movies ever?
Yep, just 7 more pages left. Should be done by morning.
Well, what if we helped?
Really? You'd help me by sitting here and writing it for me? That's a brilliant idea.
I do have many strong opinions about Harrison Ford's treatment of replicants.
I call footnotes.
Great. You work, and I'll go get a fresh batch of books from the library. Let me just get this musical equipment out of your way.
Seriously, Erica, it means so much that you asked me down here to hang. So much.
Yeah, it's really worked out for all of us.
You are such a good person.
See? The weird kid gets it.
Look, Joe Cola. We can stay up for days.
Fine by me. Just write the paper.
Nah.
God, you need brothers like that in real life.
I know. Well, and they've become my brothers in real life in a way. So mm-hmm. it's been awesome.
You have released music. Where can we find your music?
iTunes, Spotify, all of the socials, you know, pretty much you can find it in YouTube.
Okay, good. And you've actually gone to Nashville a couple times, right?
Yes, I live there whenever I'm not working.
Oh, really?
So I've fallen in love with Nashville. It's such a great place.
All right. Literally, you know, we've said this a million times because here's what happens. Every person has said that.
Yep.
And then they say, we'd really like to shut the door behind us.
Yeah. Because
too many people are coming.
Oh, yeah. No, it's gotten really packed. And I can't really complain because I'm kind of part of the problem. I'm a little later, I don't think. But at the same time, it's getting some LA traffic over there. But I love Nashville. It's such a different feel. And I don't know, it reminds me a little bit of home being in Dallas. And so, yeah, I like being there and making music. They're the best talented people there.
It's all going Haley's way.
Yeah,
Goldbergs, of course, encore episodes here on KTLA. New ones, Wednesday nights at 8 on ABC. Really nice to meet you this morning.
Thank you,
thanks
guys.
So much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
We want to get to some breaking.